late summer vibes. And a party sensing changing fortunes after nearly a decade in the doldrums. High hopes of advances at the general election.
Great stuff.
Still a lodestar, and today's generation aims to repeat the late Paddy Ashdown success in taking the party from a pinprick in the polls to potential kingmaker.
Look behind you, Mr. Ashdown.
Yes, well, I'll be around there in a second.
So, capturing true blue seats, but departing from elements of the Ashdown philosophy. Scrapping the penny on income tax for the NHS, an idea which grew from a similar Ashdown pledge for education. Rebuild relations with the EU, but don't mention the B word. Wouldn't want to frighten the horses. And scrap national housing targets to keep the home counties happy. This conference said no to that. Onto the stage with the message of the day.
We have taken chunks out of the blue wall. We have made it start to crumble. Now let's smash it for good.
And then a highly personal story as Ed Davies spoke of how, as a child, he lost his father and then his mother to cancer. And today, a legal right to start cancer treatment within 62 days of an urgent referral.
It was a tough period as a teenager, but it was much, much tougher for Mum. Yet those years were also special. They gave me an incredible bond with my mum. She was so strong, so resilient, fighting to be with her boys, even in the face of such a cruel disease. I like to think I learnt a lot from her. I was 15 when she died.
Complete silence in the hall as Ed Davey told his story. And then to end,
we are the strongest campaigning force in British politics.
A pre-election rallying cry.
The British people are desperate for hope. The British people are desperate for change. The British people are desperate for a fair deal. And we are the ones who can make it happen. So let's get to it.
Well, beautifully constructed, delivered with a great deal of self-confidence, and with material which must strike right at the heart of the Conservative government's performance, but which brings to the people of the United Kingdom a sense of hope and possible achievement.
You know, at Lib Dem Conference, it is a bottom-up democratic party. We make the policy. The job of the party is to make that prose. The job of the leader is to turn it into poetry. And I genuinely think he did that today.
What do you think of this dialing down certain sort of signature Liberal Democrat themes? We're not got the penny and income tax for the NHS. We're not talking about Brexit. It's don't frighten the Tory horses.
Well, I think some of it's just pragmatic. You know, the cost of living crisis, everyone is hurting. We don't want to be targeting individuals with tax rises. That's just not the right time to do it. But also, we start where the electorate is. We want to talk about the big issues people are talking about, and it is the NHS. It is cancer.
How times change. A combination of COVID and the Queen's death means that the last time the Liberal Democrats had their annual gathering was right here 4 years ago. That, of course, when Jo Swinson presented herself as the candidate for Prime Minister, a position she was going to use to reverse Brexit without another referendum. That did not exactly resonate with the electorate. But now the Lib Dems sense new beginnings, and many voters, fed up, they believe, with the chopping and changing of Tory prime ministers, willing to give the Lib Dems a fair hearing.
Taking his leave for now, but this leader believes his party is firmly back on the map.
Nick Walsh, right.